I'm Dave Cathy, the food dude. Friday afternoon, we got some big stuff coming up on Tuesday over at the Francis Tuttle Culinary School. Mark Dunham, Chris McCabe, you guys are sort of spearheading this effort. What are we doing here? Chef's event. Talk about it, Mark.
Guest Chef Series is a series that we've been hosting now. We're on our second year. And the idea is to invite regional, local, and even national chefs into the culinary school so that our students can experience different styles of food. They can train with different chefs. Hopefully it helps them grow a little bit. And the chefs get a chance to interact with our faculty and with the school. And so, you know, the grand idea here is for these students to get a different range and a different approach to food so that they're better prepared when they get out in the workforce.
Sounds great. And it's a chance for our local chefs to grow a little bit too, hopefully.
I
like Chris here.
He's taller today than he was yesterday.
Yeah, so Chris, this is your first time doing this, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Spring is carefully creeping its way towards
us
here.
It's in the air. We spring forward on the Saturday, don't we?
Yeah. Hopefully the weather will
match.
Will catch up. But your menu sounds like it's going to be right on point with spring.
Yeah, spring is an exciting time for, you know, vegetables and seafood. Everything starts to come in the season, and it's probably one of my favorite seasons. You know, you get fiddlehead ferns, morel mushrooms, spring peas. These are all exciting ingredients that, you know, you don't really get to see all year round.
Yeah, they're fresh and pretty, and so you can make beautiful plates, and you can't hardly beat that, like, fresh from the ground flavor.
You take for granted some ingredients that, you know, because of California, they're available all year round, but, you know, certain things, you can only get them in spring.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, take us through a little bit. What are you going to feature?
Well, we're starting off the day with oyster panna cotta. It'll be some well-fleet oysters set in a nice light little mousse, some seaweed potato chips, and a champagne foam. Then we follow up with a blue crab bisque with morels and asparagus. And then we finish with a spring lamb. It's a little porterhouse steak with snap peas, spring peas, pea shoots, pea puree.
Everything peas. I like it.
Fresh milk curd and awesome. Red wine sauce. And then we finish with orange blossom honey souffle.
That sounds great. Well, I was at the last one. It was a great event. You've got a lot to live up to, but I also have no doubt, you know, that you'll live up to it. The defending champion of the Oswald Culinary Cook-Off. So what restaurant of yours would this dish be most likely to appear in?
Maybe Red Prime.
Mm-hmm.
Probably for the lamb, we're actually thinking about putting it on the menu.
Yeah, there you go.
It's kind of taking a little bit from all the restaurants. It's great to have so many concepts because you could not really just focus on you know, one style of cuisine. You could just do whatever you want to do. Just find the right restaurant for it.
Well, and that's part of the deal for District 21 is it also gives these chefs a chance to get out of their digs, right? And they can come to the restaurant and do something maybe that they wouldn't do at their own restaurant. Mm-hmm. So they get to, you know, stretch their creativity a little bit, and everybody benefits. The students benefit.
Yeah.
Our restaurant benefits because, you know, we kind of break the mold with breaking the mold. So in that constant kind of revitalization of the concept and of the food, I think it's healthy for the city.
I agree. That's great. So tell us again exactly, you know, how this benefits the students beyond just the hands-on.
Well, so beyond the hands-on, from the financial perspective, all of the proceeds from every one of the dinners goes to the Francis Tuttle Foundation. That then goes back to students. So a student that may be struggling with money for scholarships, a student that may be struggling with gas money. I mean, there's all sorts of avenues to help students. So that's the primary financial focus for the dinners.
Very good. Well, that's obviously great. So everybody out there is obviously going to want to go. So how in the heck can they do this?
They go to d21dining.com. Okay. They can buy their tickets on the website. They can also see the upcoming chef events for April and May. Mm-hmm. If you're having any trouble with the website, you can always call the culinary school at 717-4944 and ask for Diana, and she'll help you out to get tickets.
That's right, and it's $50, right?
$50 for four courses, or $60 with wine pairings.
A little vino.
That's right.
That's a great deal right there. All right, and then next month?
Next month, we have John Midori from Picasso.
Great chef,
and does tremendous work with vegetables. So it'll be interesting to see him come back in the springtime. And then May, we have Mark Brown from Oklahoma City Golf and Country Club.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Very good. Good lineup. Get out there, get your tickets. See you on Tuesday.
D21dining.com.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thanks. Appreciate it. Yeah.